Hi. Just sketched out some house houses, just a collection of trees and of buildings and trees. Snow scene. I'm going to go over this with ink, and I'm not sure how it'll work out. I've got my little bits of stick that I picked up on the beach at Fort de Soto in Florida recently, just sharpened the bits of pine root that when the sand was washed away from the roots with a hurricane. So back to good old England. So I've rubbed these down, the tips, with sandpaper because they, I think when the acrylic ink dries on them, it makes them the surface go very hard, and it loses its a bit of its porosity, which is always very, very nice. To absorb a bit of ink and you get some texture. So I'll just quickly, this will be a line and wash, but bit of snow coming off the roof from these things. Most houses were the drying kilns, air dried for hops, mostly in Kent because that's where most of our hops are drawn. I'm using black acrylic ink, acrylic artist's ink, that's all. It's waterproof when dry, but you've got to make sure it's dry. So we'll just show a bit of the snow dropping off the roof here. Okay, another roof here. This stick does hold quite a bit of ink. But you have to make sure you don't get any blobs. When you put your colour on, the contrast between the black and the white does lessen. I would just put a bit of stuff there. A great exponent of this type of painting was Roland Hilder. Died in the 90s. Excuse me, I have a swig of my tea. Been out for the bike ride this morning with the guys. The Old Men Riding Badly on Bike Society to Merton Abbey, but along the River Wandle. We have a cup of tea in the cafe opposite. But there is a mill that's still working. It's 12 volt electricity from the mill, it powers the mill. Although they are taking some electricity from the grid to power the LED lights, which is a bit of a shame, but there you go. Okay. Come across here, do this one here. Don't want this looking all nice and pretty because it's got a load of snow on the roof. But it's thawing out, so it's starting to slip on the roof. I can show some bits of wood and stuff that's propped up there. Support a large barn here. We were asking the guy in the mill, he was giving us information on it. The mill itself, the water wheel, used to have an output of about 7 horsepower. But he said the water authorities take so much water out of it now, but it works less than half its old capacity. All right, okay, so we'll have a bit of a ploughed field here. Could use a brush, but hey, that's a... I'll put some sort of bits and pieces on there. So we want a road coming around here. Or a track. And on there we'll have some... I'll use a brush now. Just to get some nice shrubby stuff showing through the snow. Oh, we just show a bit of a tree here. Okay, something like that. Now we'll put in some it's got a bit heavy there. We'll turn that into a bit of ivy though, I think. Okay, there's some over here. Because this is a Fabriano paper, it's quite smooth. So I have to be careful because it's not catching too many high spots on it. So that's why it's blobbing a little bit. Let's put a couple of right, just a bit of texture. Okay, so we've more or less got a maybe I've done too much ink work on that, but it's good fun, isn't it? Light on that side, a bit of dark in there. Okay, give that brush a bit of a clean. Now I've got to make sure that the ink is as dry as I can get it, because if not, when I wet the paper, it will bleed which you don't want it to do, so I'm going to tissue it off, because I know there are some bits that are still wet. Then I'll give it a try with the hairdryer. Right. Take your headphones off, because I'm going to blast it with this. Right, that should be all right. So that's a £130 Fabriano. I'll just sort out my wires on the floor. Excuse me. We might get disturbed by Freddy the kitten. He's having a bit of a tough time health-wise. He's doing all right, but he's had all sorts of things. He had a big ulcer on his tongue. He had it two and a half weeks. And he got that, and then we're getting over that, and sorry, I'm down here with my electrics. Got over that, then he got a weepy eye. It cost us a fortune in vet bills. So, but he seems to be okay. We've got the grandson here today and yesterday, so I didn't do much yesterday or anything yesterday, because well, he's got a cold and he's a bit hyper with the kitten. So they've been running each other ragged. So they might come up. So if you get disturbed, I do apologise. I'm sure you won't mind. Right, I've got my palette of lemon yellow, raw sienna, alizarin crimson, light red, ultramarine, burnt umber, Payne's grey and burnt sienna. I'm tempted really to do a two or three colour one on this. Burnt sienna, Payne's grey, and yellow ochre, I think. Payne's grey, yellow ochre, or burnt umber. Keep away from the reds. Oh no, yellow. I'll use some yellow in with the grey and the burnt umber, burnt sienna, to do some foliage there and the field. So here we go. Finish my tea. Right, I'll wet the paper all over. I've got my new hake, so got a nice bit of water on there. So let's just nice and wet. Well, not so that it's sloshing down your board, but now you can see that's still picking up a bit of that colour, so that black. And just a touch. Right, now, burnt sienna. I'll just give it a clean. This is a bit, I haven't done a painting since I think last Wednesday. Well, it's a busy time of the year, isn't it? I didn't work on Saturday because I had some carpet work to do for an old client. Well, not an old, he's young, but he's an old customer. So that took care of Saturday, we passed Saturday. Right, there we go. Right, burnt sienna. You need plenty of cloth to wipe your brush to get the excess moisture off. Right, okay, so. I think we can mix a little bit of yellow in with that. Coming down to the horizon. Remember, it's a winter scene. And we'll just pull that down there. Right, okay. Right, now we're going to some Payne's grey. I slightly less distinct when you come to the horizon. I'm mixing a bit of the sienna back with this here. Right, now a bit of Payne's grey for a background, just the distant Kent hills. Okay, so that'll do for that. Right, let's get a bit of colour in there, I think. You clip the paper as it grows. You see, the drawing is the thing that takes the time, but I did that quick pencil sketch. And right, I'm going to use this round brush for a change. I'm just going to put in some green. So the yellow and a good dollop of burnt sienna and some Payne's grey, plenty of yellow, because one of the warm colours, because we're in the foreground. So let's just using the edge of the brush. This is a sable mix, but it's more mix and sable. Some nice darks. As that's drying there, I'll get in some sienna and grey. That'll probably move a little bit, but it doesn't matter. I mean, it'll bleed into the wet paper around it. A bit more bluey grey in there. All very, very quick, and then we'll come in here. That needs to be darker and solid there. Or even warmer. Right, let's do this area. I'm just going to reclip the paper again. Now, we need some colour on the roof. So we'll put a very, very, very light grey, just as a reflecting the top of these clouds. Right. So the light's coming from here, so from here, yeah. So some of that, let's put a bit of shadow, so that is, if that is just showing on there, we'll put a bit of warm in here. And a bit darker there maybe. That's supposed to be the side of a porch. but or a barn attached. So let's see. And that will be just a bit of a shadow, that will be light. So this would be fairly light, the roof on the right. We want some sort of colour, so let's mix a bit of that. So let's just put a bit of reflection on there. But not too much colour. And then nice dark, as if that was a wood. Wooden side. Now I'm going to wet this round bit of this post. So that'll give the impression that there's light coming from there and it's going around the corner into the dark. Then we'll put a bit of shadow. It's quite a nice little brush, this. Okay, get some shadow under this roof. This will give the shape of, hopefully, the shape of the snow just sort of falling off the roof. Sienna. And here, just warm that up. See, the painting is not exact at all. And we've got bits of snow on there, but bits falling off. So we'll put a, as if the snow, most of the snow has come off of that. So we'll just wet the tiled area, and we'll put a nice sienna down there. I'm just touching the shadow area there, yeah. Okay, so now some light sienna. Right. Okay, let's put in some of the ploughed stuff. So it all helps the drawing, but it sets the all that black ink, it sets it back into the background, if you see what I mean. We're reducing the contrast of it. So very, very loosely drawn, painted on here. Right, we can put in some nicer lines. Some of this. A bit of green. Oh, sorry. Making a noise there. Right, a bit of shadow on there. And we'll put a bit of a shadow coming in down there, across here. And I reckon we could probably put a little figure in. It's a figure brush. give me one. Losing my brushes. I have one in here. So, of course, a bit of burnt sienna, which is lovely and red, sort of red. Let's put in, only quite large, but not too large. So let's put him here. And then we'll put in with some footprints. Right, I just wanted a bit of calligraphy in the in all this. Now I was going to put a bit of green in, haven't I? So let's do that. So heavy greens, yellow, sienna, and lemon yellow. Well, that will be showing up, is it? So let's just put in some trees. Load of these because they're those spindly windbreak type of elms and. Well, we've been lucky, we haven't had any disturbances. But I'm sure you wouldn't have minded. So I'll just put in some twigs and filling in the gaps really. I hope I'm not masking you. This Fabriano is a very good paper. This I've got to thank Stephen Cronin for putting onto this nearly 2 years ago now. It's what he uses and it's really good for this sort of work. It's a bit slick. You can't paint. I've tried to paint directly onto it, dry, like I can, but it doesn't really work. You need a heavier, more robust paper for that sort of work. But anyway. Not a lot more I can do to that. I'll put a seed through it, but put it in a mound. Let's get more paint on there. Probably could put a bird in it. Just a bit of a. Just bits of hedgerow sticking through. I think that needs a bit more. That's just about how to do it. Right, we'll. Oh, I know. A bit of that colour reflecting in that white. I left that white, didn't I? So a bit of white, a bit of yellow. So let's just. It's good to make the snow similar sort of colours of the sky, but leaving bits of white. Right, okay, that's a bit of masking tape. Okay, put the old mount on there. I think I could just make him a little bit more. Right, that'll do. Birds. Okay, so there we are. One quick Kent scene. Oast houses. Winter. Very quick. Let's bring my camera around a bit so you can get a better idea of it. Square on. There we are. So just before Christmas, I'll try and do one tomorrow. And then that'll be it for a few days. So thanks for watching. Wish you all a Merry Christmas. Sorry, wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Keep practicing. Bye bye.